In Half-Life 2, when you jump forward or backward, you get a small speed boost. This may not seem relevant, but it's an important part of understanding how accelerated backhopping happened. More specifically, when the player presses their jump button, passes all of the conditions needed to perform a jump, like being on the ground, they get lifted up, and then the horizontal speed boost is added. But right before the speed boost, the game ensures it's in single player. This is why there's no ABH in Half-Life 2 Deathmatch. Then the game creates a vector, forward, that represents the direction the player is looking in. Z is the vertical axis in Source, and the Z value of this vector is immediately set to 0. Then it's normalized. Normalizing a vector means it's manipulated so that its length is only a single unit of whatever distance you're measuring in, while also keeping the vector pointed in the same direction. This is useful in some cases because trying to work with vectors of inconsistent length can be unnecessarily difficult. The behavior is perfectly symmetrical within world space, so for simplicity's sake, let's just imagine the player is moving straight east, meaning our forward vector would always be 100. Some of you may have spotted a problem. If the player is looking straight up, the forward vector would initially be 001, but since the z value gets set to 0, we would end up with a useless vector of 000. The same would apply to looking down. Well, don't worry. You can't actually look straight up or down in Half-Life 2, only 89 degrees above or below horizontal, so the vector will always be valid. I'm using a Left 4 Dead 2 player model here because the Half-Life 2 player model is just this. Valve wrote the next step of the code in a very terrible, no good way, so I'm going to present the code in a way that won't make you throw up. A value is chosen for what percentage of speed to add on. If the player is sprinting or ducking, the value is 0.1 or 10%. Otherwise, it's 0.5 or 50%. Now we have to talk about movement speeds. Half-Life 2 has 5 base movement speeds. Sprinting, where you move at 320 units per second. The default movement speed, which we'll just call running, is 190. Then there's walking. Walking is a movement option which is pretty much just a holdover from Half-Life 1. In Half-Life 1, its use is to give a movement speed that's quiet but still faster than crouching. In Half-Life 2, it's pretty much useless. When you don't have an HEV suit, the game forces you to walk. The walking speed is 150, so not too far off from running. Finally, there's of course crouching. The speed of crouching movement is approximately 63 with an HEV suit and 50 without one. If a combination of sprint, walk, and crouch buttons are being pressed, the game will pick whichever option is the slowest. The reason movement speeds matter is due to a new variable, forward move. This variable represents the forward speed the player is trying to move at. The key word is trying. This does not represent the player's actual forward speed at any given time, but generally it is coincidentally the same as long as the player isn't being impeded by anything. For instance, if the player is pressing their forward button and not pressing sprint, walk, or crouch, this number is 190. If they're pressing forward and left or right, it will be 134 point something since the movement is split along two axes. If they're pressing left or right and neither forward nor backwards, this number is 0. In the case that the player is holding their backwards button, the number will be whatever it would be with forward, but negative. The numbers will scale proportionately with different modes of movement. Now there's another variable called speed addition, which is forward move times the speed boost percentage. Finally, forward times speed addition is added to the player's velocity. In older versions of Half-Life 2, this was all there was to bunny hopping. Every time you jumped forward or backwards, you would be given more speed. Speedrunners would jump using their scroll wheel to get the best jumps possible. The longer you spent on the ground each jump, the more friction would slow you down. The scroll wheel's inputs can be sent very rapidly, so it's a good way to minimize friction. Let's walk through an example. Let's say the player is running forward as they jump. As I said before, we'll assume the player is moving straight east, so the forward vector is 100. The player is not sprinting, so the speed boost percentage is 0.5. The player is only moving forward, so forward move is 190. Speed addition would be 95. Forward times speed addition would be 95.00. So the player's final velocity would be 285.00. Well, the z value would be something positive because the player is now moving up, but that's not important. 95 units per second of speed would be gained upon every jump. In Episode 2, Valve sought to stop bunny hopping, so they changed how the speed boost works to make it potentially a speed penalty. The change initially only applied to Episode 2, but in 2010, this change, along with several other bug fixes, were added to Half-Life 2 and Episode 1 as well. Speed addition is now the absolute value of forward move times the speed boost percentage. Then there are two new variables. Well, sort of three. We kind of already talked about one, which, to avoid confusion, I'll call speed limit. Speed limit is the maximum speed that the player can move at in consideration to what movement mode they're using. So that's 320 for sprinting, 190 for running, 150 for walking, and then crouching is 190 if the player has an AGB suit, and 150 if they don't, since that forces the player to walk. For whatever reason, crouching is coded differently than the other movement modes, which rarely results in oddities like this. Did you know the speed at which you get on and off ladders is controlled by your movement mode? You'll move faster with sprinting and slower with walking, but with crouching, you'll move at running or walking speed since crouching is coded weirdly. Here's how it would look if it was coded like the other movement modes are. Anyway, the second new variable is max speed, which is speed limit plus the result of speed limit times the speed boost percentage. That's 352 for sprinting, 285 for running, 225 for walking, and 209 for crouching with an HEV suit, and 165 without. The last new variable is new speed, which is speed addition plus the player's current horizontal speed. In short, new speed tells what the player's boosted speed would be before the game actually applies the boost. If new speed is greater than max speed, speed addition will be reduced by new speed minus max speed. In other words, the speed boost is nerfed just enough that it would keep the player under a certain speed. If forward move is negative, then speed addition will be inverted. Finally, forward times speed addition is added to the player's velocity as before. Alright, let's try some more scenarios. The player is running forward as they jump. The speed boost percentage is 0.5. Forward move is 190, so speed addition is 95. Max speed would be 285. New speed would be 95 plus 190, which is 285. New speed is equal to max speed, so speed addition won't be reduced. In this case, it would be reduced by 0 anyway. Forward move is positive, so speed addition won't be inverted either. We add on 9500 to the player's velocity, just like before. But now let's see what happens on the next jump while the player is moving at 285 units per second. Everything is the same at first, but now new speed is 95 plus 285, or 380. New speed is greater than max speed, so new speed minus max speed is 95. Speed addition is still 95, and 95 minus 95 is obviously 0, so now there's no speed boost at all. This is exactly what was intended. Now let's see how the code holds up when you change movement modes during a jump. Let's say the player did a running jump, but before touching the ground and starting the next jump, they begin sprinting. The speed boost percentage will be 0.1. Forward move is 320, so speed addition is 32. Max speed will be 352. New speed is 32 plus 190, which is 222. New speed is less than max speed, and forward move is positive. Nothing wrong about this. Now let's try it the other way around. The player will start with a sprint jump, 352 units per second, and the next jump will be done crouching, with an HEV suit, of course. The speed boost percentage will be 0.1, forward move at 190, speed addition 209, max speed 209, new speed 561. New speed is greater than max speed. New speed minus max speed is 561 minus 209, which is 352 exactly. 209 minus 352 is negative 143. Forward move is positive. In this case, negative 143.00 is added to the player's velocity. So the final velocity is 209.00. Nice. Everything is still working just as it should. This is seemingly as rigorous as Valve's testing of their code got. Let's try that last scenario again, but this time on the second jump, we'll turn to face north instead of east. And just for kicks, we won't hold forward. Forward move will be 0, so speed addition will also be 0. New speed will therefore simply be our current speed of 352. Max speed, however, is still 209, which is less than new speed, so we'll be reducing speed addition from 0 to something negative. 352 minus 209 is 143, so speed addition is now negative 143. Forward move is 0, so speed addition stays as it is, which means it's time to add on the speed. Remember the forward vector? Since we're looking north, that's now 010. Now we're adding 0, negative 143, 0 to the player's velocity of 352, 0, 0. That's 352, negative 143, 0. Not only did we gain speed instead of losing it, it's to the south. Okay, now we'll try one more jump, but this time we'll point the player west. Forward is now negative 1, 0, 0, so we add on positive 143, 0, 0 to 352, 0, 0. Now the player's velocity is 495, 0, 0. This isn't what we wanted at all, but it gets worse. You know how it's called accelerated backhopping? Well, let's see what happens one more time. On the third jump, in which we have 495 units per second speed, we'll be subtracting 495 minus the 209 as before, so speed addition is now negative 286. Now we're at 781 units per second, and we gained more speed than on the previous jump. We haven't yet seen a case where forward move is negative, which should have its own effects, so let's do that now. We're at sprint jump speed, facing west, and crouching, which is the same as the last example, but this time we'll hold backward. Speed addition is 19. Yes, forward move is negative in this case, but remember that speed addition is the absolute value of the result of a forward move times the speed boost percentage. Max speed is 209. New speed is 19 plus 352, or 371. New speed is greater than max speed, so 371 minus 209 is 162. So speed addition becomes negative 143. Since forward move is negative, we flip speed addition around to be positive. Forward is negative 100, so we add negative 143.00 to our velocity of 352.00 to get 209.00. Well, what the hell? I didn't ask for this working code. Don't worry, this is also broken. Let's try that same thing again, but facing east. We're looking in our direction of motion this time, but holding backward. What happens now? We're still flipping speed addition to be positive 143, but forward is positive 100 again. So we've just added 143 to our speed. This technique is called the accelerated forward hop. AFH is very difficult to do at lower speeds. You don't want to spend very long holding S because moving against the direction you're moving in obviously means you'll lose speed. It's much easier to gain some initial speed another way, and then you can afford to spend longer, but not too much longer, holding down the S key because you'll have some speed you can burn through. You also need to be careful that you jump while pressing S, because if the two inputs don't line up, you'll be put back into the intended ranges of speed. In Portal 1, which has all of the same mechanics that we've discussed in this video, AFH is rather easy because the player has much less direct control of their movement when in the air, so you can in fact simply hold down S. To make AFH easier, speedrunners use an obscure control called the strafe modifier. When this control is held, the mouse will move the player instead of the camera. This lets you move around with joystick-like precision with your mouse. By moving your mouse down slightly when using the strafe modifier, you can have forward move be negative without slowing yourself down too much. This means forward move will also not be very big, which means speed addition will be near zero before being reduced, meaning it will be farther away from zero after being reduced, which means more speed gained. There is one final technique, the accelerated side hop. This is where you press back and left while looking somewhat right, or back and right while looking somewhat left. This has the same effect as the strafe modifier tactic, though it's not quite as effective. Compared to S-tap AFH and strafe AFH, ASH is definitely a lot more straightforward and easy, though it can be difficult to control in its own right since your speed boosts will come at an angle, so it's better to switch to AFH at higher speeds. You may wonder, what about pressing forward and left or right? This is called AGH, short for AGH, I did ABH wrong. So where exactly did Valve go wrong? If you ask the Source Runs wiki, it says it's with the part where speed addition gets reduced, and that's sort of true, but the issue is bigger than that. The speed reduction code needs to be completely separate from the speed boost code. The speed boost direction is based off the camera's direction. The speed reduction should be applying in all directions. For the speed reduction, forward should not be related to the camera at all. It should instead be the player's direction of motion. Even if you applied some sort of fix for ABH that leaves the original code mostly intact, there's still the lingering matter of sideways jumping. For instance, Gmod's ABH fix is straight up terrible and will move you forward or backward in weird ways. You could also just have the speed boost apply in all directions. I don't really get the point of having the speed boost apply forwards and backwards but not sideways, and have the boost be in only one direction when you're moving diagonally. In conclusion, that was avoidable.